Like, could you describe the success of your projects? How do you measure them?
Yeah,
what are the statistics?
I have metrics, internal metrics that I use to for example, for Jupyter Notebook diffs or a code review. The initial hypothesis is that data scientists do want to have code reviews, but they can't because the tooling is not there. So we deployed code reviews. It was the first thing that I worked on. And there was a huge spike in code reviews after the feature was deployed. Even if it's, I had to hack a bit how it was implemented. I implemented my own version of diffs for Jupyter Notebooks. And we saw a huge spike, a sustained spike. Like there was a jump and then a sustained number of reviews being done, more comments on Jupyter Notebooks. That means the hypothesis was correct. They wanted to, they just didn't have any way to do that. But there's also a lot of qualitative feedback that I need to rely on, because like, as I said, it's not our current users that I'm looking at, it's new users that are coming in. And for that, I use a lot of social media to get a little bit of like a temperature on what users want or whether they like the features, and also chatting with the other folks. It's funny because I went for a pub with an ex-colleagues and data scientists, and there was a bug on a Jupyter, and they almost made me take my laptop to fix the bug while there. And I did fix it the next week. But I see now a lot more data scientists coming in and asking for data science stuff in GitLab than it was before.
And when you mentioned code reviews, do I understand correctly that what you mean is being able to display Jupyter Notebook diffs correctly?
Yes.
That would then kind of result in code reviews, because
yes,
previously
exactly.
You couldn't do that.
But is it in a way of pull requests, like with pull requests, or is more about, okay, here is a Jupyter Notebook? Because I see a few, let's call them, jobs to be done around it. Like one, I've done something. In Jupyter Notebook, maybe I was doing some data exploration, maybe I was doing data exploration and model training within Notebook. I see results and I would like to get feedback, maybe, you know, where to learn, where I should maybe change something, like suggestions from colleagues. So it is one kind of use case that comes to my mind. Second, that I have not seen, but maybe because this functionality was not available, a pull request, so kind of a merge situation.
The focus was exactly on the merge request flow. So when you push a change to a Jupyter Notebook and you create a merge request, you will see the diff of the Jupyter Notebook with the images displayed over there, a simplified version. What I do, I convert both Jupyter Notebooks to their markdown forms, do some cleanup because there's a lot of stuff in there that's not necessary, maximize information and reduce noise, and then I diff those markdown versions. And then you can comment and you can discuss the markdown versions of the notebooks. For the user, it doesn't matter. Like nothing changes for the user. There's nothing like the push and it's over there. But for me, when I was data science, it's not even about the ones that use notebooks for machine learning. Those are important, yes, but for me is also the data scientists that are more focused on the business cases and where the final artifact of what their work is usually a report, and where the notebook is usually the final part of their report, like final technical part of their report. Because it's often, at least when I was at Ascentis, we would review each other's documents, like the papers towards the end or the reports. And there would be graphs and there would be stuff, but nobody would see how those graphs were generated. What was the code? What was the equations? Was there a missing plus sign somewhere that could completely flip the decision being made in the end? And that's very dangerous. So I'd say that for this feature, the most important, the most the users that can take the most of out of it are not the ones that only focus on machine learning, but the ones that are more on the business side of data science.
This makes sense. This make like this concept of pull request, code review in the context of reporting makes perfect sense for me. I was not sure, for instance, in model building, I have not seen much of pull requests to the, okay, maybe if you have a library, right, that is shared, or feature engineering library, then yes, pipelining, yes, but you wouldn't do pipelining necessarily in notebook, at least it wouldn't be my recommendation, but yeah, makes sense.
But even in machine learning, the experimentation environments, I guess, benefit a lot before you actually push your pipeline to production, right?
Yeah. And there's another concept is that for code review, for me, that was important, is that code review is where code culture grows. It's a Kickstarter to create a culture of development, a shared culture of development within with your peers. And data scientists don't have that. Not that they don't want, is that if they don't code review, they don't talk about the code, they don't share what is common, what is not, what are mistakes, best case or not. Code review for me is much less about correctness and much more about mentoring and just talking about what is being pushed. And I hope that with Jupyter reviews, code reviews, along with the regular code reviews and all of the things we have, we can push this code review or this code culture to data scientists in a more in a better way, like allow them to develop this culture themselves, give the tools necessary.